Hey guys, welcome back to Kleeps Tech. Today we're going over updating the BIOS on your Gigabyte Z690 motherboards. We have a Gigabyte Z690 Elite AX DDR4 we've got today. We need to update the BIOS on this in order to even be able to install Windows on an M.2 drive, so we're going to be doing that. What you're going to need is obviously going to need your Gigabyte motherboard. You're going to need a power supply, and then you're going to need a flash drive, preferably under 32 gigs. We have a 8 gigabyte 2.0 drive here that we're going to be using to update our BIOS. It has flashing LED indicators on it, which should be helpful in determining whether or not it's actually working. If you don't have LEDs on your flash drive, it may not be easy to tell, but we're going to find out. And so first thing we're going to do is we're going to take our flash drive and we're just going to plug it into the computer where we're going to download our BIOS from. And from there, we're going to head over to our screen.
The safest way to make sure you don't format the wrong USB drive is to only have the drive that you're using plugged in. And we'll right-click on that USB drive. In the context menu, select Format. And then we'll choose the FAT32 file system if it's not already selected. And we can just start the format with the defaults. Once it's done, click on OK. And we'll proceed to the support page for your motherboard next. Once you're on the support page, make sure you're at the proper motherboard, any revisions. Then go to the download section. I'm going to scroll down to the BIOS area. Expand that. You want to find the most recent BIOS update, which is going to be at the top of the list. Then we're going to want to download that. And we're going to actually just, easiest way is to save it directly to the USB drive that you'll be using. And navigate to that USB drive where you saved the file. We're just going to right click on that. We'll just extract it all directly to the top level directory, the root directory. So we'll just delete everything after the drive letter and the slash. Now, once that's complete, we can actually delete everything else. We only need to keep the BIOS file on there, which is probably going to be the largest file, and it'll end in whatever the version number. For us, it was the F7. We're just going to rename that by right-clicking, delete everything, including the extension. And you're going to rename that to gigabyte.bin. Gigabyte capitalized. And bin lowercase. And you're all set. All we need to do is eject the USB drive.
Now that we've got our BIOS put onto our flash drive, we're all set to get our motherboard set up. So first thing we're going to need is going to need a power supply. We're using a Superflower Elite X3 here. It's a little bit overkill for what we're doing right now, but we're going to grab the power cable, the motherboard, the 24 pin for the motherboard, and we'll grab the CPU as well. And obviously you're going to actually need the power supply. So I'll put these over here for now. Pull the power supply out. Put our packaging away. So CPU connector. We're just gonna plug that in. It's gonna go in right here. CPU EVG or CPU. And we're just gonna plug that into the 8-pin over here on our motherboard. And then we're gonna take our 24-pin. That's gonna go. One is going in our motherboard right here. And the other end into the power supply. Let's see. Like that. Like that. Alright, so there you go. Power supply is all hooked up to your motherboard. Now we just gotta plug our actual power supply into a outlet here. We've got extension cord running right to here. I'm just gonna plug this in. And flip on our power supply right here. And then now we're going to take our flash drive. We're going to plug it into this little BIOS button or BIOS slot here. This is labeled right above the USB slot we're going to put it into. We plug it in. We can see that the LED on the flash drive lights up. It's a good sign. Now when we come down here, we've got a little button that says Qflash Plus. We're going to press that. Our power supply lights up. It's actually kind of cool to see that happen. And now we can see that there's some kind of LED indication proving that the flash drive is doing something here. So hopefully everything is going as planned. All right. So as you can see, our Qflash button actually has a little orange LED indicator flashing when it's updating the BIOS. If you only see it light up for a few seconds and then stop, it probably means it didn't work. It's going to take at least a few minutes to update, I assume. So something to keep in mind when you're doing this. So we walked away for a couple minutes. We gave the motherboard some privacy. We let the BIOS do its thing. We came back. The Qflash Plus light is no longer flashing. Our power supply has shut itself off. And we have a solid LED light on our USB. So our BIOS should be updated now. And we should be good to go once we get the processor installed. And now we've got everything all set up. You can see our BIOS is updated. Thanks for tuning in, guys. We appreciate the support. If you found this content helpful, please consider subscribing. It would definitely help us put out more content like this. And we'll see you guys next time.